But here, let's do this. It's 2023. We're going to go to Outlands website. Not Outlands Market, UO Outlands. OBS. Game zoomed in. Let's see here. There was a post. I believe it's this one right here. We've got active development, and we've got the development pipeline as of April 2022. And this has been kind of updated a lot, or it gets updated fairly often. So let me make sure. Where's the bottom of my screen? There. And that's perfectly fine because that's most of the URL stuff. So let's take a moment, chat. Since we're just chilling and I'm scripting right now, let's go through the active pipeline. I'd love to hear what y'all have to talk about. What are y'all thoughts on some of this stuff? I want to talk about this because it said PvP update. I want to talk about this before I even start scrolling down. Where are y'all at on factions? What are y'all thoughts? What are y'all thinking? It's not out yet, right? Factions. At least I haven't seen mobs of people just murdering each other all over the fucking place. I'm looking forward to it. I am not interested in factions at all. So factions are on the test server. I just didn't know if they had made it into production yet. I remember seeing the development stuff first release before I went on my break, and ever since I've been back, I hadn't really noticed it, so I figured it was still in development. Disappointed they are gating content behind it. I mean, like, I feel you, Straw Hat. I really do. I'm looking at it as a way to kind of grow. I'm not very interested in it, and I'm not a big PvPer. Neither am I, Amish. Neither am I. Dude, I'll be honest with you. I don't know how many people have been in my chats recently when I die in PvP. I usually rant about just not being a god, even though I have zero skill. So, I personally still think, and I'm not going to get into the topic, I still think it's a little weird that spell interrupt is at like full percentage, unless you go into wrestling. I think that one's weird. Because of the disadvantage it creates for mages, and like the only CC you have as a mage is you have a wall, which gets counteracted by rope that was introduced by UO Outlands, and you've got paralyze, which you can just spam macros on bags that auto pop that instantly every single time, 100% of the time, and you've got poison, which is supposed to more hinder healing. But you got auto scans and auto spam health bots. So everything that a mage can do in its out of box toolkit that was provided by Richard and team back in the 90s has a 100% macro enabled counter for it on UO Outlands. There's just a bit of an imbalance with that. Anyways, I'm not touching it because I don't know much about PvP because everybody says PvP mages are insane. Yet, I mean, like, I feel like they're insane from an ambushing perspective. But I think if you get a Dexer on top of the mage and it's a PvM mage and not a PvP mage, you're kind of fucked 100% of the time. Mages are the best in PvP, but wrestling, parry, and alchemy, and you are unskilled. Let's talk about this because I'm not upset, so y'all are going to get me to be able to talk about this in a mood where I'm not upset about it. I would love to see the devs at least acknowledge the imbalance of PvP because it's so 1997. Dude, sorry to lean in for this. Is that just a shitload of S's? OSCO. Thanks for the follow, man. How you doing? How you doing? What I would love to see happen is not necessarily them admit it. Let's say that. That's just fucking stupid. I would love to see them overhaul PvP. Hey, man. Thanks for saying hi in chat, dude. Hi, how you doing? How you doing? But I would love to see them overhaul PvP. And I don't mean, like, flip it to flip it, right? I would like to see universally a system put in a place that's meant to be kind of paper, rock, scissors. Things are supposed to beat other things. Not 100% of the time, because skill is what overcomes the paper, rock, scissors in an RPG. That's where, like, that's in my mind where PvP skill comes in. But I would love to be able to see things like bards becoming useful again. I would love, or in general, like, there's no rhyme or reason you couldn't convince me that the peacemaking ability when used on a player shouldn't literally do the exact same thing as the paralysis buff. That trap bags shouldn't get rid of paralysis. Like, we could probably figure out something. Maybe chivalry does something useful. Like, all these things could do something useful. And I know what everybody's thinking. That would just be overpowered because everybody would do everything. No, because you still have 700 skill points. If you give everything a use, then you get a system where there's templates that can be done. There's a diverse profile of skills. Think of the PVM in this game. Like, the diverse amount of things you can do to go and smash in a dungeon. They could do the same thing for PvP. And it could be done. It would be difficult. We'd maybe never see a level 4 of a dungeon ever again. But I think it could be done. I'm so sad that backstabbing doesn't work in PvP. Backstabbing should 100% work in PvP. I think it does, to be honest with you. I don't think it does to the extent, but I think it does. And, like, trying to stealth up to somebody is an art form in PvP. I thought it did. Honest to God, I thought, you know, we'll check the wiki, but I'm pretty confident it did. And I'm perfectly fine with being called out on that not happening. All right, so if we go to the wiki, we'll look here at the skills. Where is backstabbing even at? It was under stealth, right? Ambush. Backstabbing. Oop. Players attacking other players from stealth will make the same backstab sound effect, but they will receive no such. See, I told you got backstab. You get the sound. You get the sound, baby! Let's go! Hey, Owen, if you're listening, let me give a universal fuck you from all the backstabbers out here for even fucking putting that in the game! Oh my god, that is literally a cock in the ass, guys! What is that? Which, it makes the sound, but doesn't go kaboom. Can someone say shooting blanks, please? Oh, God. Oh, my God. That's so bad, it's funny. That's so bad, it's funny. Here, go 200 skill points. Or 220 skill points, 100 in hiding, 120 in stealth, go an entire fucking theme around your character of sneaking around, finally going 12 steps at a time when you know you can barely catch up to somebody, go to hit them, and I'll let you go, ugh. But... Oh, dude, for Sigma. That's fucking funny, dude. That's horrible. Yeah, think of the game we could have. And I'm not going to say that this dream of mine of an overhaul would not have imbalances to it. I'm not saying it should have imbalances to it. All I'm saying is if they did things like backstabbing, then we could have actual assassinations. If they had barding, we could have people literally piecing people and paralyzing them, maybe playing Discord and putting a debuff on them and lowering their armor for a minute, playing provoke, and I don't know. You could probably provoke them and make them attack for 5 seconds, and like provoke could be a disarm, and like literally you build an entire class of bard around for PvP centric around crowd control, which is typically what it is in the Dungeons and Dragons universe, is a crowd controlling element, and that's what it is in the PvM. You just take another approach at it. So bards could be having a bard in your group in PvP could actually become useful. Having a paladin in your group could become useful. When you introduce samurais, that could, and ninjas, all of this will build a better Ultima Online experience, because that's going to open up more than a skill kit that I could have Googled from 20 fucking years ago that is still relevant on the server. And that's all I'm saying about PvP. And all of that entire rant started with the fact that I'm getting interrupted on my fucking spells because a mage has to put 100 points and a melee ability to be able to be effective, but a dexer doesn't have to put 100 points and a mage ability to be able to be effective. That's all I'm saying. That's all I'm saying. This is not an area of gray. This is black and white. Yeah, but mages don't miss spells. Maybe they should. I don't know. But let's face it, even if they added that into the game, I would never miss. I mean, whiffs at E-Bolt? the miss thing is true. I'll give you that. But I mean, wouldn't that be where resist magic comes in? I don't necessarily need to miss, but like, you can spec and resist spells, and like it would, my spells aren't even as effective anymore. You know what I mean? But that kind of ruins PvP through the ages. Eh, fuck PvP the way it is now. If you want to go play old school PvP, go to UO Forever. I mean, like, I'm just saying, like, the thing about Outlands is this is not supposed to be a. Outlands is not old school Ultima Online. It was obvious of that when they overhauled the entire world. They got rid of the entire world. They got rid of all the cities. They got rid of all the fucking dungeons. They built a brand new universe. They overhauled every single skill in the game. They introduced aspects, mastery change, codexes. They introduced more fucking systems than God has ever put into Ultima Online. And there's no reason they shouldn't do the exact same thing for PvP. Just because old school PvPers of UO would get ass hurt. You know, I mean, like, I get it, but I think it opens up the door. I think it opens up the door to something more interesting. I do. I've been asking for spell accuracy for ages. That would make so much more balance. And like, yeah, but don't put it on the melee ability. I personally think I plan on going wrestling here soon. And I'm only going wrestling just because of the mono refund chance. I'll be honest, the old crit system sounded kind of cool too. Because I could totally see me going a crit build, but that mono refund sounds fucking tits amazing. Wrestling is way too strong for. Are you talking about way too strong for mages? I mean, like, eh. Sure. But it's. I mean, it's strong. Yeah. Are you saying it's strong in PvP or PvM? They're 100% unhittable. I mean, that could be the case. Wait. Hold on. Are you talking about just like the chance to hit with a? Are you talking about wrestling in the chance to hit with a melee attack? The issue is simple. Mages with wrestling are way too overpowered. Mages without wrestling are wet noodles. Dude, fucking spot. Spot on. But I'm just saying, like, that, in my mind, that, I mean, that should be addressed. But I would like to see, because if I wanted to complain about this and stand on my soapbox, I want to go stand on Alter Ego's soapbox and recognize that his character is a fucking wet noodle in PvP 2. Right? Because it is. He's playing a fucking Dex, a melee Dexer with no range capabilities, and very, and the only healing he has gets turned off in PvP, and all of his other four abilities, Music, Provoke, Peace, Disco, all are nulled in PvP. Like, that shit is stupid. To realize that that happens. And I realize that on my bar. So, like, I'm just saying, like, this is where we can respect what UO was 20-something years ago when we were all a lot younger. And we can say maybe a sprinkling of innovation is not such a bad thing. Could we agree on that? I'm not saying, like, I'm going to sit here and say the best solution, because I'm not a PvPer. I wouldn't know the first thing about the, like, balancing these systems. I could throw ideas against the wall and say, hey, what about this? And someone who understood this could go, that would probably be a little overpowered. And I would argue, if that's overpowered, how would we create a balance to that without taking it away? Because that's what PvP is. PvP is all about creating a balance. PvP is all about creating a balance with having, here's power, and here's the counter of that power. And it's not always, you don't have to always have to have the same thing. We'd be like, okay, well, here is, say, like, oh, well, here is power called mages, and then Dexers are the counter to that, and the counter to that, you got to go this. Like, you could have, you have hundreds of skills to choose from. Using those skills to have multiple, that's why I say paper, rock, scissors. So then having a squad of PvPers could actually mean something. Hell, I hit up Luthius a few months ago, and I said, you know what would be really cool? A healing codex. Because in most of the games that I play, I actually really like playing a healer. And what's the one thing UO does not have? A healer. It has a mage, but it doesn't have a healer. It has a chivalry, but it doesn't have a healer. It doesn't have something that focuses on, I'm focusing on how to heal everything. I want to know how to heal. And it could do that with a codex, in my mind. I feel like we could either have that with a codex, or we could have that with a skill tome, right? But I feel like there's a way that you could figure out how to become a healer. Yeah, I mean, could you just water aspect? Come on now. I don't want to increase my healing. I don't want to increase my healing. I it would be cool, but then you would have to create a balance to that, right? Because RPGs are all about creating balances and counterbalances. If you had someone who was, like, I shit you not, guys. If y'all had a guy in your guild who was just, like, a try-hard healer, and they're like, yeah, you bring me along, I'm not doing any DPS, I'm just going to sit there and heal, dude, your groups would be amazing. Could you imagine that? Usually we have a bunch of sweaty fucking mages pumping their dicks off in the fucking corner with as much flame strikes as humanly possible, and you got your one tank over here going, fuck, I need to heal my bandage! And they're like, god damn it, I gotta blow mana on this asshole. Drink a pot, you fuck! It's like, that's how UO plays, right? It's like you're all there for self-sustainment until, like, your shit slips and then you throw a healer. We have more healers than DPS. Sounds like you're in a shitty guild. Shit. Shitty guild my ass. We three-man bosses if we have to. Shitty ass guild my ass, dude. We don't need dedicated healers. I'm just saying it would be overpowered if you had dedicated healers. Don't go over here. Three man is easy. Okay. Yeah. Fucking eight man it. What are you in a fucking? Are you in face? What guild are you in? Come on. Let's see. What guild are you in? You taking 25, 30 people to a fucking dungeon? You taking 25, 30 people? I'm just saying. Don't just go around calling guilds shitty. I'm just saying, like, it would be nice to have something dedicated around healing, because the only thing that's in healing is, right now that improves healing is in the Majory Codex. And I think it would be something special for people who like to sit back and play healers. I only have, like, 6 people in my guild, though. I mean, like, there you go. You have more healer. You have 6 people in your guild, and you have more of them are healers? I mean, I don't. I'm at a loss for words. Straw Hat, I like your fucking emoji. I'm going to move on. All right, so we have gotten very far in this fucking list of development pipeline discussion. I don't even know who the fuck that is. Like, no offense. I'm too new to this server to really fucking to know all the players right now. So I don't know. I've never fucking seen that guild. I'm just going to let you know. It was the strongest guild in the server. I've never seen your guild. I think we got a little bit of a troll here, guys. I hope so, or else that's just funny. But then again, I'll be honest. I see new guilds all the time. You ain't shit to Laginus, dude. Fuck yeah, dude. You ain't shit to me. I'm a fucking Aegis rat, baby! Oh my god, dude. I get what you're saying, but you want more dynamic PvP. Exactly. Exactly. I want to diversify the 700 skill templates. And I'd like to get it to where PvP is interesting. And there are people, there are great PvPers out there that I think get bored of the same old, same old. I do. And I'd like to be able to say, hey, here's this fucking amazing game. It's called Outlands. And it's got one of the best PvP systems in the entire game. Some of it's broken. You know, we turn on backstabbing so Persigma can get his fucking jollies on, aside fucking being able to shoot blinks all the time. So some of it may be imbalanced, right? And that's okay. Like, PvP is not always balanced, but that diversity would be fucking cool as shit, though. Tell this man who I am. I'm Crew Jones TV. Oh my gosh. I'm hella poor right now, but I got 40 million left. Yo, man, you got 40 fucking million. You got 200 million away. Yo, hey, man, how many torches you got? You need torch luck? Exclamation donate. I'm selling for 5 million gold. I'm selling some of my bath water on a vendor right now for 5 million gold. It's my lucky torch bath water. You need an Asura torch? Fuck, dude, I traded my Asura torch for a SSE torch right now the other day. But I will trade that SSE torch for a Oz torch. I had planned on farming Oz, and then with the weekly XP and all the fucking systems, the societies and shit, plus everybody wants Oz. For the people who wanted Oz. I can't, dude. It's miserable. It's miserable in there, so I don't plan on farming it. So I will trade an SSE torch if anybody wants it for an Oz torch, one for one. Here's your spicy take. They should populate all level 4 dungeons before bothering with factions, which may be 10% of the player base. Dude, there you fucking go. That's not a hot take. That's not a spicy take. That's fucking drawing truth right fucking there on the line. That's fucking drawing truth right there on the fucking line. Don't get me wrong. I think factions sound interesting. I don't feel like dying in fucking dungeons because I decided to join factions with my guild and now I gotta worry about even more cunts in the fucking dungeon. Am I fucking right, guys, or am I fucking right? Dude, you walk around and I'm not saying I don't enjoy the thrill of the death, right? I don't like it, but I don't want it, but it needs to be there. It has to be there. But for fuck's sake, there is nothing to kill on this server half the time. If you go to the dungeons that are popular and fun to farm, I think SSC is a good dungeon. It's difficult, and it's got justifiable rewards, and it's there. I like Aegis, but fuck me, is it full of trolls. Oh my god. Let's see here. You guys are all just trammy nerds. I don't completely disagree to this. Yo, fuck yeah, dude. I love me some Tramiel. Or are you talking about Trammy the Thief? But I think you're talking about Tramiel. Yeah, dude, we just fucking love to sit there and sell Aya Newt. That's what we do. your playstyle choice is wrong. Come on, man. Hey, man. Don't be telling him his playstyle choice is wrong. What the fuck is Aya Newt? What the fuck is an Eye of Newt? Chat, I think we found someone who you don't know what Eye of Newt is? God damn, man. And you're going to sit here and tell me to get off my soapbox? Some late OSI shit? Who uses that? I don't know, man. I just say it. I used to scam people with fake Aya Newts back in the fucking day. Oh my god. Alright. I never played when Aya Newt was a thing. Dude, it's just, everybody used to say, like, if you're in Tramiel, or I'm sorry, at Brit Bank. If you're at Brit Bank, dude, there's always some fucks. I quit OSI in like 2002. Yeah, then that would have been during the time frame, and that's probably about the time frame I had been playing. Was around 01 to 02, probably around then. You've assigned you find a seller for that Pulma torch yet? Good lord, who's selling a Pulma torch? Oh. All right. Want to buy torches. And since I can't get them. Yeah. Dude, I'll pay more, nerd. I can't sell my torches. Like I would, oh god, it's like the hardest thing to wrestle with. Farmed over 7 million gold. I don't think I farm that much. Like, I don't know. Unless, are y'all just looking at, when y'all say I farm over 7 million gold, are you just looking at your bank and you've seen your bank increase by 7 million gold? Is that what you're saying? Or is there like, were you talking about like server stat when like it increased by 7 million? Like your literal fucking bank? No. Oh, looking at chainmail? Okay. Chain experience is based off gold? Okay, oh. Are you fucking kidding me? Hold on. How in the fuck? The other reg for fucking, what's the other reg for invisibility? I see I have 439 night for Oh, dude, did I grab the wrong reg? I might have grabbed the wrong fucking reg. I don't know how I'm out of fucking, more reagents are needed for this. Hold on. Invisibility is six circle, invisibility. Oh, fucking grab Black Pearl. I didn't grab Nightshade. God damn it, chat. Hold on. Well, I'm only, what, one-tenth? I only got one-tenth of a way. All right. Give me a second. Oh. Wrong macro. Wrong fucking window. Give me a sec. All right, so... go to the right book. Go back to the house. All right. We'll just start the end game. Spent too much time farming in hyper competitive dungeons. All right. So for chain, I can't check chain experience. I don't have the. I'm not on my main. I do know I went from my eighth. I got my eighth link, which I was a little bit of ways away. I was probably like a quarter of a way away. So I got my eighth link, and I'm almost at my ninth link. So whatever that is. So keep in mind, during a majority of this event for me, I started a summoner build with an aspect at rank zero. So I kind of like restarted all over. I had to get my summoner codex. I'd already marked out my magery codex. So that's what kind of helped me get going. But I wasn't like hitting the ground running on a fucking like well-prepared character. So a lot of it was kind of me soloing in a level 3 dungeon by myself with like aspect like rank 3. So I had a lot of mana issues and shit in my early gaming, but I just kind of pushed through it. All right, let's look at these fucking notes because I've actually been wanting to dive into it. All right, so we have some PvP updates for skirmishes. And that's being integrated into the factions as waypost, so we're going to skip that. PvP rewards, development status is at 25%. So for our rotational PvP events, dude, is anybody else like, fucking this snow is goddamn annoying as shit to fucking read this stuff through. It's distracting as hell. It looks cute, though. I guess that's what matters. For our rotational PvP events, as well as any new ones we introduce, such as skirmishes, we're going to look at expanding the types of rewards that players can earn from participating in PvP systems, including adding options for experience gain items that allow players to consume them to increase aspect, experience, and mastery, codexes, chains, and so on. Guilds will potentially be able to earn control-type bonuses for members of their guilds for limited periods of time based on their participation and succession in field-based systems such as skirmishes and warfare. That's pretty fucking dope, guys. That's really fucking dope. Like, I get Straw Hat 100%. I agree about focusing on some PvE stuff, but I have watched Halberd Enema play quite a bit. And if you think about it, there's not a whole lot of rewards. Like I'm shocked there wasn't a PvP torch from non-dungeon PvP. I'll say that, from like the skirmishes and stuff like that. Like you could have made like a dark flame, just a pure black flame. No, they had a type. Is there a thief torch? What the fuck? No, just a typo. Only a lantern. A thief torch. Yeah, see, that's what I'm saying. A thief torch and a skirmish torch and stuff like that. Like some of those like PvP systems would have been really cool to have had a torch to chase for folks that enjoy that. Like we have to at least admit there is an amount of community. As much as I don't agree with the PvP stuff, there is a percentage of the community that you want to maintain. 10% is still a fucking large portion of your community. Let's face it. Us PvMers, we ain't got nowhere else to go from to get this type of experience. What are we gonna fucking do? Go play fucking New World? No, thank you. All right, so this is really good. This is good stuff, right? This is good stuff. It's 25% in development, but it's good to know they're thinking about that. Yo, Sagas. I don't know anything about that. Let's check it out. What's this all about? The legacy continues. Sorry, I didn't mean to skip into it. You think they added the snow into the game? in the wind. That's a good looking town though, right? I can't tell if that's overly snow. Classic feel, new PVM system, custom map, Defiance PvP system, the original PvP of UO Defiance, League Murder System Town War, stuff like that about us. That's way too much text. I'm not going to fucking read. Join Discord, how to play. That's cool. That's cool. Okay, so, you know, there may be something else. You know what? Let's give a clap. Clap for that. I'm glad that there is some fucking competition out there. Because that's what's going to keep Outlands on their fucking toes. Right? We need competition. Competition needs better development. And with that, hopefully some of these fucking systems can start getting underway. All right, factions, we talked about this. Classic dungeons, we're going to skip this. Pyre Starter. Capture the flag PvP that will likely take place in the Stygia site, whatever. Rift. What? I don't think it's Stygia. Stygine? Whatever. Rifts in our... It's fucking a capture the flag. Alright. That's not bad. Oh, this looks dope as fuck. I saw that on a Hobbard stream. Stygian? Thank you. Thank you. Alright, we'd like... So, independent Stygian rifts. We'll likely be moving Stygian Rifts out of the daily rotational PvP schedule and instead move them towards independent Strangelands arena tournament style handling, where there'll be several Rift events scheduled each weekday or each week that players can participate in. Stygian Rifts will likely have its own standalone reward system. Okay. So that's following a similar theme. Is this not in the game, or is Stygian Rifts, is this a Stygian Rift that I'm looking at right here? And this is just adding on additional content to it. Cause I thought I saw Hobbard Enema, actually playing this. Okay. Town Struggle is now live. So Town Struggle updates will be, so this is already stuff that they released in the development pipeline. We will be making some updates to the Town Struggles to address current balances issues with the event, such as capping team size, having multiple instances of the event occurring at the same time, and in different towns, for instance, having a 66 in Prev, another 66 in Cambria. We're also considering moving towards auto-balancing based off player ELO rating, rather than using guild numbers. That's cool. I'd love to see if this is completed now, like, probably a little bit better text of also considering to what did you actually fucking do. But, that's cool. Yeah, that's live? Alright, cool. Yeah, it says right here, live. Alright, so Dungeon and PvP Murders, so they're at 95%, which I guess this technically could be live and not updated. We are reviewing the current handling of murders for global aggression restrictions and the interaction between blues and reds for PvP dungeons. We are additionally looking at mechanics to encourage more consensual sex. Oh, I'm sorry, PvP in dungeons, and add ways for PvP templates to better navigate dungeons, i.e., the war system. PKing in lower levels of dungeons is almost non-existent due to monster difficulty. What the fuck game are they playing? Tell that to my asshole for over the last couple of weeks. Jesus Christ, dude. These dungeons have been rolling with fucking reds. Three to five deep. You may see like one or two occasionally. All right, two to five deep. I'll say that. You may see an occasional solo guy, but those guys are usually really fucking good to begin with. Dude, the fucking dungeons are filled with fucking rolling groups just fucking mowing over PVMers. Oh, poor little PKers can't get to the fucking dungeons. Okay. Don't know what game they've been playing. Notoriety and flagging. All right, so 90%. Overhaul the handling of the flagging system. For contested bosses and potentially over contested such as IDOCs. Didn't they just recently do something with the IDOC system to where I think someone in my guild was telling me this. But they changed it to when you demolish your house. Like the entire area is like frozen for like 30 minutes so you can tear down a house and replace it without the fear of someone running in and like stealing that shit. So if you're trying to upgrade your home, you can just kind of take your time rather than literally having your heart pound through your chest. That's nice. That's a good quality of life. That's a good quality of life. All right, give me 1 second. Let me get some water real quick. Apparently talking nonstop is draining on the vocal cords. But yeah, let me know what y'all think about the IDOC system. Also, the house lottery system. I noticed that when I came back to the game, and that could have been there for a while. Is that new? Just the lottery, not necessarily the loot, but just the lottery of the home itself. Let me know. Oh, guys, dude, fucking chat. This house smells fucking amazing right now. Oh, my wife's cooking chili. Oh, so good. Yeah, it is fairly new. Oh, cool. Yeah, the home lottery is new. on top of the loot ones. Yeah, I've been playing it. Apparently, so this house right here was, I guess, a lottery house. The one that I'm in right here. And one of my guildmates won it right like the week I came back to the game. So I'm over here. I live like right next to Andoria, right outside of Andoria. And it's cozy as fuck. And he won this through some raffle and then sold this to me for like 5 million gold. So apparently these are going for about 7 million now. I need to get caught up on the real estate. I love UO real estate. I could see myself becoming an in-game real estate agent. And like kind of like IDOC Hunter and shit like that. I know GG's got the IDOC scene like fucking on lockdown, but I actually wouldn't mind doing like getting more like real estate and flipping and stuff like that. I like that shit. House flipping brings the big money. I know. I just really haven't gotten into it again. I've been so focused on trying to get my PVM scene caught up. Sitting on 20 mil house, but want to downsize a little bit. Yo, dude, you want to swap houses? Darken, right now. Bro. I'll leave everything in this house that I have right now. I'll flip that house for you. Me and you, we can trade. This is a good downsize. Look, it has a cozy little fireplace. It even has a server-only rare of the King's Fair. Of the King's Fair dance game. First place trophy. The Golden Plucky Musical Trophy, because I won it. I won first place in DDR. But now, all right, jokes aside. All right, let's get back into it, guys. Yeah, I really like housing in UO. I really do. What house? Oh, you're still on there. Fuck it, sorry. That reply system's kind of weird on my end. Like, it's kind of, like, super grayed out. I'm like... Dungeon Wilderness Rebalance. This is live in the game, so this went live sometime this year. Rebalancing the stats, skills, and abilities of all creatures and of dungeons and wilderness to factor in the current state of player power levels. The intended goal is to make levels 1 through 3 of the dungeons much more attractive for players to farm. and therefore spread out players who are currently congested in dungeons only in a select few areas. What was it like before? We will likely also review and update the abilities of all bosses to account for player powers. Additionally, look at overhauling and handling of boss results to include damage inflicted to boss minions for the purpose of both the results and as well as mastery link and token credit. Is this recent? That would explain a lot if this was recent, by the way. Because, like, before I quit the game, like, dude, dungeon level 3s were kind of a nightmare unless you were, like, really there. And, like, I've been having fun with the game. Thank you, babe. So, mad reps to Frosty. She's been holding down the fort today doing her own thing. It's been, like, 50-degree weather outside. She's been chilling the fuck out. She's like, we're done with this. I got that torch, and she's like, oh, thank God. I did not want to have to hit Aegis again today. So she's been just taking the day, and she just got to make some fucking chili. So good. So you got a house currently placed in a limestone plaster redoubt. I think a tower fits on an island surrounded by HITI. HITI is your HITI is your guild, right? Well, you said it was your guild, I guess. Okay. Are y'all sailors? You got a name like that? Are y'all ocean boys? Are y'all pirates? We own the ocean for long enough. Bro. We should talk. You going on any ocean hunts for that ocean torch? You need a lucky guy to come along. I'll just let you know. We let other people have a chance. I've never done the ocean game in UO before. I quit boating. You're a landlubber now, huh? All right, let's see. Dungeon expansions. Here we go, chat. Here we go. Developing status varying. Mausoleum, 100% mat completion. 0% creature completion. Holy shit. That's all they're going to do for Moz? Like, yeah, this is Moz 4. This one wing. Just this one wing. Like, here's one entrance to it, and there goes the fucking other. It's this fucking corridor. This is Moz 4. They're going to add a mob here, here, here. Here, 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 and here. That's the entire fucking dungeon. Just to log in and test and teleport to it. At $20, there's like 8 mobs that they end up putting in there. Moz is just... it's such a good design. Theme. The theme is so good, but it needs to be like 3 times bigger. Strong boxes replaced with strong box player customization. Players will now be able to purchase strong boxes with rewards on various things. Was strong boxes added during this year? Like the gold system? Was that new for this year? I love the purple, but Moz itself is Garbo? Dude, man. That's pretty cool. Yeah, I'm working up for my strong box. Last year. Gotcha. But it's still really fucking cool though. I've got my societies pumping, so hopefully in a couple of weeks, I think in about maybe like 5 weeks, I should be able to get my strong boxes. I'm looking forward to that. My life was miserable before strong boxes. How did you guys play? Same. My life is miserable right now because I don't have strong box. Gold just weighs too much. And there's too much gold in the dungeon. They're such a game changer, dude. I can't wait. I can't make gold. I have such a hard time just making pure gold. And I mean, like, I see what everybody else is doing. And, like, what my guild recommends doing is just leave it on the fucking corpse. Just keep playing. Or, like, there's no point of picking up gold. Because eventually you're just going to hit something that gives you, like, 5 million, like, 3 million, 1 million gold. Like, you're going to get some sandals or something like that. And just, like, the time it takes to constantly depot gold over a long period of time, you'll probably just lose. Or you'll gain more money just not depoting. I guess it depends on the dungeon, how fast you can get back. It's gotta be true for me, because when I go in depot, especially if I'm streaming, that can be a fucking 30 fucking minutes. That's some weird shit. Got Potter Irish thigh boots. Oh my god. The other night, if I pull my Swamp Dragon, like 2.5 million boots. Holy shit, dude. Holy fucking shit. All right, this is what all the PBMers want to talk about. Taming. It's 75% development. Tameables. Boost the 120 skill tameables. I don't think that's a good idea. I think they need to make it to where the fucking creatures of the world are not dog shit. That would be nice. I want to level taming, and I want to feel like the creatures that I have to tame and level up with it are not just completely and utter dog shit. I'm just going to say it right now. But it is what it is. Like, I can get past it. Like, other skills, just get to 100, get to 120, ignore the entire, like, level up process, macro the shit out of it, get it there. It would be nice if they have better 120 tameables. It would also be nice if they had more 120 tameables. So I don't like it focusing on just the 120, because, like, I like the LD Drakes. I fucking love the LD Drakes. It, by all means, I get that they're good right now. Like, they're good. Like, the aesthetic of them is what I like about it. Like, it's a fucking purple dragon, guys, that shoots fucking spells. It's cool. The Barb Prowler is really fucking cool, too. The Otiug is one of my favorite fucking pets in the game. And I know those are 120s. But there's some really cool pets. Zog with a follow. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you. Hoo-ah! So, I would like to see more of the in-game creatures, not just the 120s, be good. And I know that, and I know they're working on it because it's 75% in the development, duh. Because we're looking at the development pipeline. I'm curious what their thoughts are, and let's read about that. Pack animals. All right. They don't have a lot of thoughts to share right now, guys. They don't have a lot of thoughts to share. Because their only thoughts are, boost it, but don't imbalance PvP. Apparently, that's all they can say without pissing half the fucking population off. Because the PvMers are like, give us back our fucking tamers! And the PvPers are like, fuck tamers! We're gonna quit this fucking server! So, they got an issue on their hands, and the only way they're going to solve that is by overhauling all the PvP system. And moving on. Pack animals, 25% completion. Players will no longer be able to bring standard pack horses and pack llamas into dungeons. Players will be able to bring pack oxes into dungeons. We're going to bring the moo train. Rip tamers, they were once MVPs when Necro wasn't a thing. Dude, I know. I know. Now it's all about that fucking source game, baby. Players can acquire a blessed pack oxen with rewards from our various reward system achievements, blah, blah, blah. If a player double clicks, a blessed oxen token will appear 8 tiles of a stable master and will be summoned to their control. The oxen itself is not blessed and can be killed, stolen from. And it is merely the oxen token that is blessed. What do y'all think about that? I like it. Because you think it's pointless? Maybe. I mean, you gotta remind. It's I'm on a from my perspective, it's hard to give an opinion on because I have not played with Strongbox. And I feel like if you could carry like 60,000 gold a player, yeah, that's dumb as fuck. I'm kind of feeling it myself. I'm kind of feeling it myself because I'm like, if I had 60,000 gold, or if I had 40,000 gold and like 100 fucking magic items and like 8 rares, I'm a goddamn pinata. I don't need to put that on a fucking goddamn giant slow-ass motherfucking AI mount that's going to get stuck on every fucking goddamn corner of the world just to die as the mob skillet on the way out. And then everybody fucking runs up and loots that shit like it's fucking Christmas. That's the dumbest fucking. I'm gonna kill everyone I see. Good luck getting out with that shit. Horse customization. I'm glad this is still at 25%. Players will now be able to give us more money for prev coins in order to add more customizations and graphics. That's all I heard. The mount breeding system expansion. We gonna let y'all shit fuck. What? Oh, there's already mount breeding. They're gonna expand it. My wife goes, what? Amish goes back when back when packies were allowed in dungeons, people would go out stealth hunting for packies. That shit was hilarious. Automod held a message back for race, ethnicity. Allow. There we go. Sorry, we're gonna allow that. Gosh, Amish, I don't allow that fucking flag for race. Just poison them and let watch people freak the fuck out. What do you mean I can't hit my potion button to heal the fucking ox? Alright, so we got town invasion. So 60%, we know what's up. It's part of pretty much being rolled into the I think this is being rolled into the system, right? The faction system, taking advantage of comprehensive region manager system. Yeah, that sounds like more more bullshit. Weapon balances and specials and code. I think they misspelled codexes. Review, rebalance weapon design speeds for weapons currently infrequently used, i.e. fencing. This is complete. I remember the fencing update. And potentially adjust weapon specials currently considered unpowerful, i.e. fencing. Dude, how are y'all liking the fencing changes? It looked really good. Fencing's god tier. Dude, I remember I was watching your stream before they updated fencing, and when that patch is coming out, you were like, fuck yeah! Is it really god tier? Aw, oh, dude, I'm gonna have to check that out. I'm so bad at fucking as a dexer. That's weapon skill. That's what's up. Dude, I see so many wrestlers still, though. Holy shit, guys. Holy shit. A lot of wrestlers. Fencing is actually worth a shit. Wrestling lost all of its worth. What do you think when they made the alchemy changes? We have three types of people in chat. Crew, rocks, and crew rocks macing, Amish rocks fencing, and I rock swords. And we all rock out with our cock out. There we go, boys. There we go, boys. And for all the ladies in chat who rock out or jam out with their clam out, let's fucking go. And my wife just goes, woo! I'm halfway across the house. You're rich. Your opinion doesn't count. I rock all weapon skills. I'm just limited to 3 echoes. LOL, you sound like a strip club DJ. Dude, that's your first thing you've ever said in chat. My fucking man. My fucking man, dude. The McCrew. The McHugh. I'm going to go with the McHugh. I fucking love it, dude. You sound like a strip club DJ. Thanks, man. It's probably because I've half lost my voice from just talking all the time, but I'm pushing through, buddy. I'm pushing through. All right, aspects. Let's fucking check out what's going on here. And by the way, eating chili while talking this much was a terrible idea because I feel like I've got like a half a pound of ground beef stuck in my fucking throat right now. man, being a DJ at a strip club, you've probably seen some shit. Dude. You probably have seen some shit. You've definitely seen some boobies. I'm going to go with seeing some boobies. You know, I bet that shit gets old, though. If you're literally a DJ, if you work as a DJ for a strip club, because then you're going to get to know them all, and then you're going to have to deal with it all, and then, like, all you do is see naked fucking women all day long. And, like, that's got to do something to your fucking psyche. That gets old fast. Yeah, I bet. But does it? I don't know, game. I don't know. I'm hitting 40, and a little bit of titty action on the internet every once in a while. I mean, I guess you're going to fucking deal with that 8 hours a day. Yeah, that shit's got to get old. I'll tell you what really would get old is the fucking goddamn music that you would have to be playing all the time. All right, pour some sugar on me. Here we go. Fifth time tonight. My job's great. I showed up with a fucking single CD, and I'm still playing it 8 years later. They pay me for this shit. All I do is hit play and do this. And then I'll get on the mic and be like, yo, Candy's coming out tonight. Y'all gentlemen, get your dollars out and make it rain. Because she's going to make a shine on y'all candy ass. And people would be like, I don't know. All right, new aspect tier 15. Motherfucker, only at 25% completed. Add two new aspects for players to unlock. Increase the aspect max tier to 15, potentially requiring an aspect triumph item acquisition from the PvP system? Oh, shit. Hey, Straw Hat, you still here? How's that make you feel? Oh my fucking god, dude. Hi, I'd like to get my fire leveled up. I've been playing that for 2 years. I love UO PVM. How do I get to tier 15, Owen? You'll need to do factions. Dude, I could hear the fucking crickets from a mile away. That's how quiet it got. Wow. Well, it's only at 25% chat, so I'm sure there's 75% left for us to riot about that on. Aspect mount tokens. I feel like this wouldn't be hard to create since they're already fucking in front of us. I don't know how is this at 0%, but you're looking at the fucking product? Straw Hat will keep PVMing and buy it from a PVPer. Oh. Oh, that's actually pretty smart. That's interesting. Development status. I don't know how you can say 0% when they're fucking, there's a picture of it. I mean, that's got to be at least 2%. Am I right? Did I miss the definition of what zero was when I was a kid? Because this looks like, this looks like a fucking straight A, B+ right here. You got a passing grade if this is already, like, motherfucker has shadows in the game. I mean, like, it's clearly in the fucking game somewhere. Darkin's like, it's 90% completed just from the fucking picture. I'm like, no, like, I agree. I'm like, someone can't fucking count in this shit. I'll be honest, guys. We're going to do some comparison analysis real quick. If this is zero, Where the fuck was the dungeon expansion? Here we go. If that zero, what the fuck is going on with this? If that zero, we are in a world of fuck. Because there ain't creatures sitting here, right? Motherfucker, they're at zero and they got the goddamn horses already made. This is 3 years out. Dungeon 4 is 3 years out if they can call having the horses in a goddamn picture of a finished product still 0%. I'm just comparing the analysis given to me by the development team. Someone, they need a scrum master. I love this interface. The only thing I wish they would have done, looking at it right now, and I understand probably why they did it, because it would have eventually hit a wall. I like seeing this as one page. Their development concept, where it's all on one page, and it didn't have to flip-flop between two pages. What does it look like here? What does the finished product look like? Oh, show only unlocked. Look how big... Like, this is my entire fucking screen, right? We could have made this window a little bit bigger. I feel like the, this shit right here looks better than this right here. Now, don't get me wrong. This little section right here is clean. They cleaned that up. I do like the experience. I forget what it looks like when, What does it show the experience on this screen? I mean, I guess I can just like shift up back on my main character. Give me a sec. I kind of forget what it looks like. So we got the tiers, we got the experience system, right? So we got that. We lost the information button, so it doesn't tell us anything. It doesn't tell us anything about this crap. Alright, I understand they got rid of this, or they convinced this and this to like an ore system based off whatever you were wearing. That is nice. That's just nice. I like that. It's cleaner up here. Maintain dyed cubes. Manage hues. I think the top part was cleaner. This window could have been longer. I don't know if you can change it. I don't know what this does. So, a little bit of back and forth based off the development. To be honest, I can make take a horse's token. That is tied to the aspect it shows. All right. Let me jump back on here and get the leveling going again. I guess for people playing on a laptop, and I think there's quite a bit of people who play on laptops, especially for UO. I guess this would have probably been too big, because I've got like a 1440 resolution monitor, a 27-inch 1440. I could see why they would do the go ahead and add the pages, because... A, it was probably really too long if you wanted to open it up during, like, while fighting. That could have been a pain in the ass, right? But, I don't know. Overall, it's really nice. I like the overview. The only thing I kind of wish is maybe it had, or maybe you can hover over it, if it showed how much experience you had, like, where it has the number written out right here. And then it had the overview right here. I just noticed they had this section right here. This is fucking clean. Right here. So, whatever. Wardrobe Manager, 0% development. We'll be creating a wardrobe managing NPC that display that players can purchase for their house to manage their collection of clothing and preview them both in game and on the NPC as well. Players will be able to create and save outfits so they can quickly switch between favorite collections. This looks more like concept art, to be honest with you. This one right here, if you look at it hard enough, you can tell this isn't UO graphics. This is actually concept art. Yeah, this is way too fucking detailed to be an Ultima Online. And this system, this right here, would have a tremendous amount of back-end systems for switching gear, saving it onto a vendor, having a user interface for templates and stuff like that. There's a lot of development that would go into to an idea like this. So I understand why they would argue with this at zero. They have mounts in the fucking game. For fuck's sake, they release one like once a season with a different shimmer hue to give away to players. This is clearly already done, and they know how to make tokens because they got tokens out of the wazoo. Just don't get me started on that one. All right, Strangelands map expansion. I have played Strangelands, I think, twice total. I had a lot of fun doing it. Do y'all play Strangelands? Let me know. Well, let me know what you think. Let me know if you like it. So they're looking to introduce several additional maps for Strangelands. And we'll implement a rotation system where the map for Strangeland rotates each season between our available maps. 33% completed. So here's a map. Looks like we got kind of more of a foresty, almost kind of like Cambria theme. I like this. This right here is probably the best desert in UO I have ever fucking seen. Got the house like buried in the sand look right here. And like there clearly used to be some type of a wall, like a castle, and it's just been overtaken. This shit looks really good. I've been waiting for something to put outfits on as deco, like a vendor. Dude. I agree. Dude, like that I'm gonna use a WoW term. The transmog system. Yeah, that's gonna be really fucking cool. I don't know what this word is. Horticulture and brewing expansion. I don't understand how this is 20% completion and you have no description. Motherfucker, the horses were more complete than that. All right, we got supply cash. All right, so 0% supply caches. We're looking at introducing a variant on treasure maps called supply cache. Players will encounter supply notes as loot in various systems, i.e. monsters, treasure chests, dungeons, etc. In order to locate a supply cache, players will use detective lenses on supply notes in their backpack, which if they make a successful detect hidden or item identification check, will give the player a rough estimate or distance and directions to very close to north, somewhat close, etc., etc. Supply caches will only be discovered by the player holding the supply note and will not require players to kill monsters. Or to kill monsters to loot the rewards, which will function similar to treasure maps, but with some tweaks. I have a better idea. How about supply caches spawn randomly in the world to include dungeons and open world wilderness and dungeons. And fuck it, in the ocean as well, you know? You can track them with a tracker at, let's say, between 100 and 120, right? And it's a special option they add into the tracking menu, and whoever gets it first gets it. So it's going to promote PvP if you got tracking, which a lot of PvPers run with tracking so they can find blues. It's going to promote a PvE engagement for seeing who can get to the loot first. So it's a I would make it like first come, first serve, but like the question's going to be is like, how random can they make it to where it spawns? So, but I like shit where it's not like it's here to promote a PvP engagement. Like, it's sitting here for 30 fucking minutes. Who's going to get it? Kind of like an IDOC bullshit where like it gives time for the entire fucking world to get there. I think it's first come, first serve. Like, maybe you got to do something to unlock it. I don't know. Not like lockpicking, unlock it, like an in-game little thing or something like that that any player could do. It's not based off of skill. But I think tracking would be able to track them down. Like, you could probably tie it into various systems or something like that, like tracking or, like, something like that. I don't know. or just fucking announce it on the goddamn Discord. Kind of like IDOC. Loot here. Oh, man. Gonna have to go eat. Have a good one. Dargan OG, man. Have a great one yourself, dude. Thank you so much for hanging out with us, man. Have yourself a good one. Much love, buddy. Much love. It's okay. I'm back. I know you're worried. Gavel, my man. We're chilling out, man. We're chilling out. I've got two accounts working on skills. I've got Majory working on right now on one account, and I've got lock picking and disarm trap on a different account. So essentially, I'm getting my main account that Leganis is on. I'm working a second mage up on that account, and that's going to be my inscription. I would do inscription on Leganis, but I don't have the money just to create an echo specifically for that. I'm close to getting my first echo, and I'm going to finish it up through team mapping. But I plan on turning Leganis into more of a PVM focused with like major like wrestling slash some resistance added on it. Kind of like the new Pwn Star build, but I don't think I'm going to use fire right away. So I'm looking at that, and then I want to keep the other one with skinning so I can keep my skin game going because I really like the skinning. I'm excited for the supply cache though, and former glories. I don't know what former glories is, but anything where there's loot capabilities in the game would be pretty fucking cool. I don't know about that item ID though. I think it'd be really cool if you could get a ticket and it had a clue on it, and you didn't need skill to go fucking do it. Like, even though my system said tracking and all that, like, I don't know. I think it'd be a better system if you didn't need the skill. I don't know. I'm making that, I think, too. There is some good place to train that. Majory or lockpicking? So my mage, I just grabbed the regs, and I went into the new town dungeon, and I get it to 80, and then I came here into my house, and I've got a script that I'm running. Oh, lockpicking? Shit. Lockpicking's easy. Maybe. Chat. Motherfucker, dude. Did the client crash? Yeah, y'all are supposed to be keeping up with that. That's on y'all. The fucking goddamn thing says Mage Scribe progress in two corners. It was supposed to be tracking the picker. All right, hold on. Let me get the picker going. God damn it. Cat Burglar Nami. There we go. All right, so I just went to a tinker shop in town. I handed him a 5,000 gold check, dropped it in the bank, and then I just went and bought a locksmith training box, a shitload of fucking things, and I'm just sitting here, and then I got a script that I run. You don't need regs, or you don't need anything. You just hand him a fucking check for a little bit of money on it. So they can buy shit from the vendor and then you know, like literally hit the button and go. And I got the script from was it the website that Jace posts all of this stuff on? If you need a copy of it or anything, just check IRL maybe. Not in game. What? I have the scripts. Not just no gold. You don't have 5,000 gold? Oh my god, I forgot you were new. Oh my god. I'm sorry. I've just been shooting the shit with you the whole time. I completely forgot you're a new player. That's my bad. Dude. You have 60,000 wood? Bro, you're fucking rich. If you have 60,000 boards, you're fucking rich. You can sell, 5,000 boards for, I have 60,000 gold. Yeah. I 10K wood, that's like 120,000 gold or something like that. Yeah, well, you were here when I gave my speech on how to be an Aegis rat, correct? Nope. Oh, my God. All right. We're not going to take a detour because I got to get through these fucking... skinning rabbits? Jesus Christ. All right. We're going to have to help you out. Here we go again. Here we go again. Literally what Straw Hat just said, but about a 15-minute conversation just to summarize that one sentence. Go into a dungeon. Most players are going after the torches these days in the deep ends of the dungeon. If you have sorcery or any type of pet mechanic, that's good. but yeah, if you can get any type of pet just to grab the aggro for you, run past everything and loot everything. A pet. Pets, not fat. P-E-T. Papa Echo Tango. let's see here. Think about OBS fixed real quick. It's bothering the shit on me. So if I rename the... Second rename. All right, you know what? I'm not going to worry about the OBS feed. It's going to take fucking for goddamn days to work this thing up. All right, let's get back to the thing. All right, let's go to OBS. We're on the Zoom. So I made a copy of something in OBS in the top corner, and I pasted it in the other corner so you got to watch both. And I forgot, when you copy and paste something, it literally, it's just pasting the instance of the thing. It's not pasting, the function of the thing. So if you change, if you copy a text and you paste it somewhere else and then you rename it, it renames both because it's a copy of the... Fucking weird. Alrighty. So supply caches. Ah, here we go. Former Glories. Okay, let me know if any of this is good, then. Yeah, you can make some money. If you're doing gathering, you can make some damn good money for it. Lock picking and stuff like that is pretty fucking good as well. I don't think you need 5K, probably 2,500 gold. We'll get it going. There you go, man. You can look for items there, and that's what they're currently selling on player vendors. And if you can also do price checks on the Discord and the want to sell section for under trade. And then I'll give you an idea. Yeah, any type of map is going to fucking, it's going to net you some gold. But there's easier ways to get gold than selling that. Good webpage? Oh, they're just fucking amazing. You pulled up Twitch on the phone. If it makes you feel better, we haven't moved far. Alright, so Former Glories. Former Glories are ruined locations in the overworld. I'm already liking this, that players will have the potential to restore for a period of time. Players will encounter a bottled memory as rare loot through normal gameplay mechanics, which will allow them to attempt to restore a former glory of the game world that is currently in ruins. Restoring a former glory, i.e. the animal taming skill, will begin with the player consumes a bottle message, then requires the player or players to tackle a large collection of progressive spawns of increasing difficulties. You got a level 4 team out? Nice. That'll fucking net you about 30k. additionally, restoring the former glory may have opportunities for crafters to repair, restore portions of the site, or have players with other investigative skills. Sorry, the bold font in this distance. I.e. forensic, tracking, detect, scour the area for artifacts. So you can go find some shit. As players make progression on restoring the former glory, the actual map and nearby stats will dynamically change to reflect player progression. Successful completion of a former glory will reward a large amount of loot, as well as unique relic treasures. Okay, there we go. Let's see what it looks like. That's pretty cool, chat. What do you think? You get a little bottle, little message in the bottle. You go over here, you pop the bottle. You pop in bottles at the club, and you kill some shit, and you get some shit. That's a pretty dynamic concept. Looks like the brigands camp right outside of my house. Let me get some of that free loot. Hell yeah, buddy. Hell yeah. Societies. The Shadow Market Society. Again, this is another 0%er. But hot damn if the society reward does not look fucking amazing. That looks so good. I want to know what it would look like in fucking game. Probably dank as fuck. I don't know, dude. They've got it to where they can create really good-looking armor now. Oh, my fucking God. All right. Sorry, I like to open my presents before I read through it. We are considering introducing a brand new society called Shadow Market that will be based off of a commerce-slash-merchant themed of players doing jobs where they accurately... where they are acquiring trade goods, illegal items, and long-lost relics and treasures. All I can understand is the illegal goods. Some examples of this jobs would include stealing black goods from creatures with specific types similar to from Monster Hunter Society, completing supply caches, participating in former glories, and completing or raiding trade caravans. No, fam. I mean, don't get me wrong, like, the gear looks good. That fucking staff looks amazing. All right, let's scroll down. Let's scroll down. We are aiming to add a large number of new society-specific clothing that can only be purchased with the society reward system. Chat, tell me that doesn't look. I'd love to see that staff with the random hue system. Oh my god, dude. $80 later, you don't get a fucking dark theme. Looks good. Dude, that looks amazing. The trick is going to be, A, mages don't use staves. Let's circle around that bandwagon for 5 fucking seconds. Is that going to act as a spellbook? Or is that going to add as a macery staff? All the Dexters in here are like fucking rubbing their nipples at this, like fucking hell yeah, fuck those mages. Finally, they recognize my ultimate skill. Alright. This looks really good. This looks really good. That's better than that better be a Transwalk spellbook, too. No fucking shit, dude. I think they said they are reworking the wands, so it might add the mage staves. Dude, that would be really cool. That'd be really, really cool. Also, dude, talk about carpentry to me and like the carpenters being like, oh fuck yeah, I can't wait for that. Fucking finally something cool I can do with my wood besides make a fucking chair. I actually really like carpentry in the game. Huh. Oh, dude. All these clothes are looking at, and then other stuff is already on the societies. I'm like, are you serious? This is on a society already? Dude, shoot me a picture on Discord if you got something on what it looks like in-game. I want to know what this looks like in-game. Does it just look like the normal robe like that I can go buy from a tailor in town? Or do they take the time and add some like critique to it? Because I think they said they can finally do that now, right? Is build like custom in-game items and not just all be paper doll graphics. There we go. That's my getaway of showing it. Those drives are still pissing me off. No, I went too far. Right here. Perfect. Oh my god, dude. I just can't win in this game. Fucking. Alright. Dude, I really like that. That staff is fucking baller as hell. And that might be why it says complete now live. Alright, chat. Holy shit, chat. Let's get the fucking claps in the chat for that one. Thank you. Thank you, thank you. Captain fucking obvious. I went right past that in my reading. Yeah, I was thinking since it said Shadow Market and this shit's fucking gray that, you know, I put one and two together and said, oh, well, okay, maybe these are the rewards for the Shadow Market since this is what they're talking about. But yeah, thank you. Well, it says it's complete. Where's the fucking staff? Dude, my man, thank you for calling me out on that one, dude. I fucking buzzed right past this. This is fucking cool graphics, though. This is fucking cool graphics. All right, the trade caravan improvements. Update trade caravans to have more interactive elements besides autofollow, including potential opportunities for crafters and better creature difficulty. I think the system for, I like trade caravans. I've done a few of them with my guild. I thought they were really cool. I don't like the progression system to get the caravan. I don't. I think putting that around gathering is a little weird. Although, don't get me wrong, we still smash the shit out of it with all the skinners. But it's just... it's something. I don't understand the lore to it. How about that? So they are looking at improving the system. I love the trade caravan idea. I love having this little car. So the trade caravan, for those who are kind of new, is essentially you do a farming mechanic that gives you a progression bar. Once it gets to once it gets full, your guild can do a trade caravan, where the caravan is you escort it from one town to another. And essentially, it'll spawn creatures throughout the caravan run. I think players, like i.e. PKers, can attack you and harm the caravan. And I don't know if the players, if they harm it, get their a reward from doing the harming, and the escort people are there to escort. I don't know if that part is actually a thing, but ideally is, from a PK's perspective, if you fuck over anybody, I guess you're a winner. But they're looking at doing a review, so that's always fun. So it's in a pipeline. It's at 0%, which means it's just a backlog. Right? This is just future planning. Now, I would love to see them have... How about this, chat? Guys, let me know what you would think about if they had not a post like this, but how about a schedule? A forecasted schedule of when they would like some of these features to be done. Because I'm seeing about another year and a half worth of bullshit still here. So when they update this, it would be really nice to see if we could get, like, what are you targeting maybe in a per quarter? I think monthly is a bit too aggressive, but if you had like three big releases throughout the year, and knowing that they don't do them in quarterly like that, they do them a little bit more. Schedule is a bad idea. People will consistently bitch about things. I don't think so. I think that's project management. I think project management 101, you should be able to put a little bit of something together to say, this is our backlog of all of our ideas, and these are the things that we're actively looking at in some reasonable order of which we're doing development. Like, people can bitch all they want, but it still does. It holds them accountable, and I think it holds them accountable a little bit, but not a lot, right? Because you don't want to say, this is what we're doing and we're fucking never going to change. That's stupid. That's not software development at all. But I think giving so many ideas like this, and I know that, I think they posted this like halfway through the year for like, as of April of 2022. So they posted it 4 months into a year. So they posted about 2 years worth of development for a 1 year project. And like a lot of this shit, and we're looking at this the first day of the new year. How far did they get with their pipeline for a new year? Most of these things are still at 0%, right? So this post in itself is when we're looking back at what were their thoughts 8 months ago, it was very ambitious. And a lot of the stuff that's on this list is now complete. Super kudos. The dev team is amazing. But in a list, because this isn't prioritized, right? And it gives the player base a little bit of ideas around, okay, here's what they're trying to target, so we can be not necessarily expecting, but looking forward to some key elements of things. And then what are your ideas that you're looking to develop, but you're not really, you don't plan on putting time towards for the next, 3 to 6 months. That's easy project management, and I'm not saying it could easily be done in a day, right? That's work, but that in itself is a skill set that's part of the professional like development community, and could be done. So it would be nice to have. I'm not going to sit here and say they have to have it, right? I mean, like, we're talking about a fucking free game that was probably a pet project that spun into an actual hustle. So I'm not going to sit here and say they have to have it. It would just be nice to be able to set some expectations. So you could have, here's a shitload of ideas that we're thinking about putting into the game, and here's what we're kind of targeting for the actual development, so not everybody thinks they're going to get everything in the next 12 months, right? Because they had to know when they put this list out that there's no way they're going to do all of that. All right, anyways, so trade caravans. So we got player loadouts, which is at 0% again. Add support to be able to quickly swap between loadouts for things like codex aspects, echoes, and stuff like that. This would be really cool because it kind of already exists a little bit in a Razor script, and it's at 0%. We could probably, hey, Jace, if you're in the chat, dude, you could probably bump this to 20% in a week. Or probably get it to 80% in a week. No, jokes aside, this would be really, really cool. And like they would have to create like databases and shit like that to be able to like save all the templates on the server side, because you wouldn't want to save that shit locally. I would assume you would probably want to save that somewhere on the server. because if you like lost your computer, you'd still want to be able to come back into the game. Like, in-game systems need to be stored in a game. But that would be a really cool thing. It's at 0% as well. But it's hard to gauge, again, 0% because the clearly developed horses were at 0%. Now, this next one, guys. This next one. This is a big one. This is the big boy. This, in my mind, is probably where a lot of their time went this year. This animation thing is the most important. It's the most aggressive, impressive update to me. Absolutely. I've been waiting to get to this. This is probably where most of their time went. This right here had probably the most scope creep. And if you're unfamiliar with that term, it's where you had a scope and it continued to creep. It got bigger. You thought it was going to be this and it ended up being this. You know, you're like, oh, yeah, that should take me about 3 weeks. And then 5 months later, you're like, fuck, it's still going. Scope creep. well, that's a little bad planning, but scope creep is where you keep adding and adding and adding. And my guess is, from a perfection perspective, it kind of just ended up that way. I don't know. I could be off on the scope creep thing. But this is the most important. This is what's going to add all the value. This is what's going to make them all the monies. This right here is what's going to change the fucking game. And it's being able to add custom animations, overhaul and remove the original animations of UO while still maintaining the initial significance of UO, adding custom artwork, custom animations, custom player movement, and everything is going to revolve. This is a foundational core development piece right here. And it's really good that they took the time to work on this. So super claps. Super claps to the developers for taking that on. Because this is what's going to take the paper doll game and put it into the actual game. You think you want your paper dolls looking cool? They can make your characters look cool now. Right? So this is going to be phenomenal. Dungeon chest rebalance. Rebalance the loot of the dungeon chest and expand the system. It says it's at 75%. But unless they plan on doing more, I feel like this is at 100. Because I know they overhauled the dungeon chest system for the remove trap and for the dungeon explorers. And it's an actual good thing now, right? Like, we actually see people walking around picking chests in dungeons again. Phenomenal. Good job, team. Good job, team. So we got the trap overhaul. we got the development trap. The traps overhaul. We got the development status is at 10%. The trap system for players will be overhauled to address imbalance with trapper builds related to PVM farming templates. We will potentially get rid of remove traps, the remove trap skill, and merge it with something currently into detect hidden. Similar to how bow crafting and fletching was merged into carpentry at launch. I didn't know they did that. We will consider introducing some synergies around other builds, such as stealthing and snooping, being able to place bombs in monster backpacks. Add quality of life, QOL, quality of life features such as shift click context menu options for players to quickly place favorite traps, add commands to quickly place favorite traps on their last targets, or their last trap at the location to improve ease of use. Where are my trap gang at? Where are my trapper boys at? Rise up. Chat. Where's my trap gang at? I know you might be lurking. I know you might be on other builds, but I've seen some trapper builds. And some of the YouTube videos, that shit looked amazing. That shit looked deadly AF. Where's my trap gang at? That looks fun. This looks like a really good system to be able to do. It looks like some good work, and I love it. Anything that's going to help improve that interface to where it's not going to require some giant-ass Razor script by the player. I like the command systems that they do. So that's what's up. The wand overhaul, which is, I think, what we were talking about a little earlier. The existing wand system will likely be overhauled from top to bottom, both in base handling as well as functionality of item identification and as a support skill. Handling for fortune aspect will likely be adjusted as well to, in regards to wands. A little mysterious, but that would be kind of interesting. I'd love to see my mage be able to equip a wand and, like, throw a little star, little magical balls at monsters while I'm casting my spell, or while I'm out of mana, so I can meditate and still do damage. I mean, I get how stupidly overpowered that just sounds to be able to DPS as a mage while fucking ooming and getting your mana back and not disrupting meditation, but I mean, give it to me. I need it. And Darian Colony Defense, 5% complete. The Andarian Colony Defense is an instant castle defense style PVM event where players will have to cooperate to overcome waves of NPC enemies to defend the castle. Players will adopt templates similar to Strangelands, with each excelling at a particular role, i.e. scouting, defense, crafting, harvesting, construction, support, etc. Similar to Strangelands, the event will be scheduled to occur at similar times. 5% complete. Only some team mappers use traps from what I've seen. I don't know how old it is. It could be fairly old, but I remember seeing some, was it a Pwnstar video? It's probably a Pwnstar video, let's be real. Essentially, you would pull a shitload of mobs and throw, like, traps on the ground and click a button and, like, the whole fucking thing would explode and, like, everything is instantly dead. So, that's pretty fucking dope. I don't know anything about that build except for it looked amazing.
Buddy?
Alright, this Andaria Colony Defense, though, sounds phenomenal. Phenomenal. And I like the fact that it's a PVM event. I do. Hopefully it stays a PVM event and doesn't become, like, some buttfuck gank thing. Because the whole entire, like, castle siege idea sounds really fun. I get into that shit. Dark Age of Camelot castle sieging, but more of a PvE thing. Ooh. All right, so we got bombardment tournaments. Add support for bomber. I'm sorry, not bombardment. Bomberman tournaments. 0% complete right now. Add support for Bomberman tournaments and other unique events. That's a fun item. I like Bomberman. It's a fun little thing to do. It's like a little mini game they added into UO. You can get there through the I forget the name of the damn thing, but it's through one of the moon gates. And you can go play that with some friends. Let's see. Houses. Developing system. 33% completed. Add new housing styles. Yes. And clean up issues with existing line of sight, courtyard issues, and housewood access. Add options. Let's talk about that. The housing styles. DOC was great. Was the greatest siege game ever. RIP Mordred. You played Mordred? Holy fucking shit, so did I. I if I could go back again, I liked my time in Mordred, but I really wish I played on one of the main servers that was more RVR based instead of like the free for all PvP. But you were an officer in Legends and founded oh my god, dude, this shit takes fucking back. That shit takes back. Dude, you and my other friend would get along so well. I never got super into the scene, but like him, he would play kind of a two-man with some buff bots scene, and dude, they used to just go around fucking smashing people on a minstrel and a necromancer when it came out. Dude, that necro game, when it first came out, dude, he has videos of him taking on like fucking 9 people. It's just fucking stupid. It was super fun. Just sit there and you're a little ghost, and you're like, get your little stir straw going. I got your laugh, bitch. Dude, I know, right? I was a merc and a wife was a cleric. I tried to play a sorcerer. Oh my fucking god. I was so bad at Dark Ages. I was terrible. All right. So, dude, I'm going to give my fucking tip of my hat to Owen on this one. Their houses are fucking beautiful on the server. I love it. What do y'all think, chat? And the new housing that I've seen pictures of, oh my god, look phenomenal. The only problem I have is there's no land to place them, and the biggest houses they have are so fucking cool. And I get it, if you're one of the rich boys on the server, you're like, fuck yeah, that's why I'm buying property. And what they did with the iDock system, or not the iDock, like the decay system, is really cool, because that'll go supporting, like, okay, hey, we got bigger houses, or we got different types of houses. So now it's going to sponsor switching the models of houses to newer models when they come out. And I think that's going to be really cool. I think that system was probably needed as a foundational system to better support new houses. Because everyone's going to want to upgrade to the newer houses, right? But no one's going to want to fucking lose their house just to upgrade it. Like, that shit'll never happen. I will at least admit, this is my view, and I know it's 99% of people will disagree with me. I think they should get rid of the courtyard. I'm just going to say it. I think you should get rid of the courtyard. Like, to be the ability, not the courtyard in general from an art perspective, the capability to teleport into your own courtyard. I don't have one. I want one, and I will use one, but I feel like the house design system and the shit that you see in the open world revolves around the courtyard. And to me, because I like houses, I get tired of just, like, fucking everything's the ghetto courtyard and courtyard. Should be able to mark on porch and steps. They could solve that instantly if you could just teleport into your house. I'm just going to say it. If you're a house owner, kill the entire courtyard seam so people could actually go and have the house graphics they want and not the functional graphics where it look like, here's the tackiest shit in the world, is where you got a guy with a courtyard and a big ass house, especially the limestone ones that are fucking huge, right? And they've got their little itty bitty courtyard, which is this little square of their house, and all of their chest, all their stashes, everything is within an 8x8 tile. Because they want to be able to teleport, hit a button, shit it all out, and then get back into the action. And then the rest of their house is just like, the rares and stuff. And I'm just like, but it's in their courtyard. I think I'm just going to say this. I want my courtyard to look like a fucking courtyard with fucking trees and flowers and shit. When I first saw the courtyards, I was like, that's what's up. I can have a fucking garden. Now I look at it and all I see is fucking, like, capabilities that I can do for depoting in front of my house, which is going to be ugly as fuck. Sweaty yards. It's not a courtyard. It's a sweaty courtyard, dude. That's exactly what it is. Like, it would be nice if they just fucking admit it. People don't want to teleport in front of their house and get ganked. So they're going to buy the things that they can teleport into their house, which creates not an imbalance. It's just an interesting concept of everyone's going to use these 5 houses in the game. And that's it. Yeah, I agree. And it makes a little bit of sense. And I'm not gonna say it, I don't think it hurts anybody. Does anybody think it hurts anybody if you if you're a co-owner or a friend in the house? Or I'm sorry, how about this? If you're a co-owner and you could create runes or mark runes in your home if you were a co-owner. And they made it something like that, like that would be that my mind would be I'd like to see that in the development pipeline. 'Cause I think it would make the server from a visual perspective as you walked around and saw the houses of the world. I think it and now that they've got the system to where you can tear down your house and place a new house without having to worry about it, I think it would promote a little bit better overall sense. I can see Bug City. I can see that too, but then again, I'm like, I would argue the same thing about courtyards. I miss the days of Robin and Key. Oh, fuck that, dude. Are you fuck that? I mean, like, don't get me wrong. It's always fun, that nostalgia. But go drop $40 million on a house or 40 million gold on a house on this server after fucking farming your ass off for a year and a half, and then have that key yoinked in a fucking second by fucking by a thief. Dude, Jester would be like, I'm all about that key gang. Logic would follow. Mages should only be able to mark within their house a bare ground or not. I think so too. I mean, like camping, there's no reason you can't camp and teleport into your house either. You know what I mean? Or shiv gates, right? I mean, they already diversified the capability to gate in the game, and I think rightfully so, with using camping and chivalry to also be able to do teleportation. And I like that. That's a great idea. I just think it should be able to be done going into your house versus popping outside of your house and running in. Although I will not lie, there's something to be said about being out of your house and then using the fucking front door. It would just be weird if that was like that's your house, because then you never use your front door. It's kind of like, in the real life, like you either use your garage or use your front door, but one of those two doors you don't ever fucking use unless you're in an apartment, which I get. I mean, But once you own a house, you'll figure it out. Most likely you use your front door and you never use your garage unless you are able to actually clean out your garage, and then you use your garage and you never use your front door. And you always look at that going, we never use that other door. That's how our first guild was made with seven people, LOL, outside of Vesper. Dude, that's awesome, dude. That's awesome. No real reason to keep the courtyard exclusive except to preserve their own value. That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. And I don't think there's a loss of value for those people. I think it's going to take the weight off their shoulders to allow them to say, finally, I can get the bigger house that I wanted because the bigger houses don't have courtyards. Or I can swap out a model for something that I like. I think it's more of a weight off their shoulder because they don't lose anything. And they didn't lose value. I mean, yes, technically the value of their home would have gone down, but in theory, the value of homes would go up. The bigger lots would go up. So did they technically lose value? Agree on or unsweet their courtyard. All right. That's a fun topic, though. I think if someone likes to actually take this shit past my chat, dude. I think we it's an easy discussion if y'all want to get a discussion going about this. Clip it, fucking throw it on to the Discord, on the official Discord as suggestions, and be like, we hear people in Leginus's chat, we 36 people, to include the streamer. We agree that these things should be done, these demands. Demand one and only demand one. We want to teleport to our houses and not have to buy a courtyard. Or get rid of the courtyard system. That's easy enough to do. I what are the other? And I think that's going to make that. All right. We're going to move along. I'm going to circle back and say everything over again. All right. Mastery chain restyle deeds and dies. I'm glad to see this is at 0%. Allows the players to swap between mastery chain styles and allows them to use dies on their mastery chains. And like, All right, let me get a show of hands. How many people leave their chain in their fucking inventory? You wear it? I wear mine from time to time. I kind of just got tired of it re-equipping it. It matches with my torch. Same here, dude. Same here. I got the AKA. I don't have one. Oh no. You wear it too? Gotcha. Yeah, I used to wear mine. I just gotten aware. I just leave it in the bag. I mean, maybe if they made it to where it didn't fucking fall off your corpse, that would be a good system. The blessed gear doesn't get unequipped when you die. Now, there's a fucking concept. Blessed gear doesn't get unequipped when you die. So you don't need to spend 10 fucking minutes or creating a razor script. I get the razor script. But bogging down your razor script time frame from getting your actual armor re-equipped. What do you think about that idea, Chet? That's not a bad idea. Because I know when I die, I'm like, God damn it, I got to put all this shit on. And I don't even have all this shit. Like, the blessed stuff. The gear, I understand. But, I mean, like, the blessed? This just goes in your bag to double-click again. You're like, fuck. All right, so we talked about the housing styles. An add-in option for players to auto-stash mounts on entrance. So it looks like that got completed. And add unlockable house customizations such as trash barrels and house pets. I thought there was a trash barrel. I don't know. I don't know what theme a trash barrel would be. Oh, fucking Jesus. All right. Mastery chain restyle deeds and dies. We talked about that. So shrine, I got a trash barrel in my wagon. God damn, dude. I took up a third of your fucking walk-in space right there. Shrine overhaul, 15% completed. Overhaul shrine corruptions to be more engaging and challenging for players with new mechanics and interactivity. Adopt player-based scaling and accommodations on how many people are present at the event. The second line I agree to. Adopt to scale it based on how many people are at the event. But the first line, I like the shrines. Just summon mobs, kill the mobs. Is that at a heart? Hold on, guys. All right, are y'all good? We back? Oh, I bet you know what happened. That's probably funny. I wonder if my my headphones turned off because it was recognizing that there's no volume. Because all I'm doing is talking on my computer. That's kind of funny. Power off after 30 minutes, power management. I'm going to leave that on because sometimes I forget to turn my headphones off. All right, we're back. Thank you. All right, so when did I go off? Let's just go back to the top of the page. So the shrine overhaul. So shrine overhauls developed the status 15% complete. Overhaul shrine status to be more engaging and more challenging for players with new mechanics and interactivity. Also, adopt player-based scaling to accommodate how many players are present at the event. So what I was saying before Logitech so rudely interrupted me was I like the second line of that. Sometimes those shrines go a little bit too quick. I mean, like, there's like 30 people at a shrine. It just dies instantly. Even on the final waves, it's shit. Sometimes it shit just gets fucked. But from an engaging persistent, I'm curious on what their ideas would be from an engagement perspective. Because, like, I like the essence of what the shrine is right now. Like, it's a little bit of a wave-based event. Some shit's going to spawn, some more shit's going to spawn, and then some more shit will spawn after that. I wouldn't mind shrines were like world boss fights. I don't mind a difficult boss fight, like a world boss per Sigma. I kind of agree to that. I think the problem would be, it's like, how do you balance a difficult encounter like that, where it's announced to the entire fucking world, right? Because shrines are publicly announced and on Discord announced. I don't know how you make that more engaging or more have more difficult bosses with balancing around the thief and PvP. Yeah. Yeah. That's what I'm thinking. It's like, it's too easy to kill people when people are struggling to deal with a boss, like a hard boss. You think so? I don't know. I don't think turn it off. I just think there's, I'm not saying it's a bad idea either, because I like it. I'm just saying I like watching the world burning down. For fuck's sake. There it is. There it is. He's like, those are the events where I bring my iron gear and not my average iron gear. And I just loot everybody. Hashtag stealth gang. You fucking rat. It's like, oh wow, I can go and backstab this mob, then go loot this dead guy, then go over here and stand next to this other guy who's about to die as well. Hashtag efficiency. Oh my god, I love it. I love it, dude. Persigma, you're a rat. I love it. Oh my gosh. Alright. Mastery chain update. Didn't we just talk about the mastery chain? Okay, yeah. 0% completed. Review the current mastery chain bonuses and look at introducing additional types such as damage to disease targets or thieves guild oriented or nated ones. Look at more visual styles for mastery chains. Bonuses such as additional types. I like this. Damage to disease targets. I like that. I like that, dude. Holy shit. Amish. What do you think? Damage to disease targets. Are you fucking gang for that? Oh, dude. All the necros in the world got their fucking hands in their pants on that one. The necromages are like... Because typically, a damage to a specific type of target is stronger than just generalized damage. Dude, holy fuck. Give me that shit today. Oh my god, I'd have to buy some prev coins to increase my gold limit just to fucking score that shit. Gold me up now, daddy. I need it. I like how they literally put damage to disease targets as an example. I'm like, fuck. Thieves Guild would be really cool. I like the Thieves Guild stuff. I really like thievery. I like the idea of the PvE concept of thievery as well. And I really like the backstab builds. I think those are actually really cool builds. It's weird because I don't remember seeing so many of them, and now I see a shitload of them. Like, they're really, really big now on the server, which is kind of funny. And I could see myself leveling one up. It's probably a character. Persigma, I might be chatting with you a little bit. So I would probably level that up on its own character just because it's going to be obviously shadow aspect. And yeah, I don't mind doing that on a second character. All right. Armor customization, 10% complete. Introduced armor customization as rewards that allow players to restyle standard armor types into custom ones. And I think we heard about that, where you would be able to go in and say, hey, this is what I want my armor set to look like for, like, plate wearers and stuff like that. So this right here and this right here are linked to each other. You need to get this done so they could create custom graphics so that they could go in. So you got this. If you really look at it, there's a lot of things that are linked. Interdependencies. So you've got your character animations. Then you've got your wardrobe sets, right? So be able to test things out and see what they look like. And then I think there was a system right here on... Nope. Where were we at? Player loadouts right here. So you got player loadouts. So foundation, get this done first so you can create armor. Then you've got player loadouts and kind of transmog systems right there. And then you have kind of the viewing system right here to be able to test out what things you want to create. And then you got the coup de grace of the whole entire fucking thing, where you can take that entire thing and then apply it to things in the game to on top of existing armor. So you don't have to. So then the dev team can focus on creating new armor graphics while applying it to the existing battle system. That's fucking genius. It'd have been nice. So feedback to the devs. When you make the post for 2023, if you see this, and I actually hope you do, and I know earlier we talked about having like a little bit of a projected timeline, even if it's like a rough projected. A lot of these, for me, because I'm looking at it as a software developer, or just a project manager is more my forte. Having these grouped under essentially an epic, because I look at these as individual features. I know I'm gonna get a little weird here, a little technical. So I look at these as individual features, but having them grouped as an overall epic, so that players can see kind of like you got this, and this. They're all part of a kind of a common idea, and then writing around that idea so that the players can be like, oh, fuck, they're going to do this and try to get this released, this and this. And maybe not all of it in the same order, unless you want to order it for us. And then kind of be like, here's our grand idea, is to introduce an entire way of managing your clothes, having in-game systems to store those loadouts, and then applying it to your current gear so that you don't have to go and acquire brand new gear. And then overhauling it so that gear isn't just a paper doll system, is also applying to your in-game character. Like, that is, from my perspective as a consumer of this product, advertising your development pipeline like that to your consumer base so they don't have to like scroll up and down and have it all memorized and stitch it all together, but saying this is what we're thinking from overhauling the player agency of our system, will be more attractive to people when they read these posts. Like, don't get me wrong, it's fucking amazing. Like, I can't stand up right now. It'd fucking break my desk. But this right here is fucking, like, just putting it all together, it's just like, you know what I mean? Bracket stats. All right, we're moving on. Bracket stats, 66% completed. Audit the stats page for players to ensure that all temporary buffs for players and bonuses are trackable in the viewing system. Yes. This is good. This is really good because we'll be able to sit down and not have, you know, necessarily have spreadsheets. Do I have it open? No. So I got sent a spreadsheet the other day to be able to track my on Discord. Let me find it real quick. I think it was it Rook? Did you send it to me? We've been talking a lot, Rook. Who sent me that? Was it Fuzzy? Oh, no. I know who sent it. There it is. So I got sent a spreadsheet on being able to track mana refund chance by typing in aspect level, mana drain rank, elder charmer level, wrestling skill, the quality of your book, and it will tell you what your actual skill is and what the current cap is. And you can play with these numbers and it'll automatically calculate. Like, having this built into the game, so players, when they look at what's in the game, understand what's going on with the game, this is good wins. This is a good winning system right here. All right. Guilds. Looks like we got a couple things about guild mechanics right here. So, guild mechanics 50% completed. Expand support to the guild system for guild masters to see to set the rank required for guild members to perform a wide selection of features such as customization, which rank sees boss summoning notifications. I think there's some. Let's keep reading. Add the option for guild officers and guild masters to be able to request a guild roster and have it automatically sent via Discord or a web link. Add a comprehensive guild roster log showing dates for all recruitment, promotions, and names and guild masters or guild members. Yeah. Add progress tracking for guild members for dungeon bosses and trade caravan systems so guilds can see which of their members are contributing toward them and how much. I understand the system. I do. I see it's at 50%. I understand a desire for this system. I think there's things on this list that we've already talked about that clearly should have been prioritized first. I'm just going to say it. Like, not going to lie, this is not World of Warcraft. This is not, I have 40 people to take to a raid, and I need to figure out who gets what. The loot is a redistribution of essentially gold. You're not worried about this mega amount of player crap. And honestly, just divvy it all up evenly at the end of the fucking night anyways. Like, we don't need DKP system in this fucking game. And I'm not saying this is what this is advertising. I do agree it would be nice to be able to export your guild roster so you don't have to type everybody's names. That would be kind of nice. But if depending on the amount of time that this is going to take, and granted, you're 8 months in development, and this is only at 50%, I wonder why. Like, there's a lot of stuff going on that everyone gets gets to use. There's a lot of really good systems around this. And I get it. Eventually, you do have to circle back and tidy up guild mechanics. I don't know. I think I'm going to be a little biased on this one. I would like to hear from the guild leaders in the guild. I'm not a guild leader. I'm not an officer or anything like that. I just, some of this stuff, I'm kind of sitting here like, yeah, it'd be nice to be able to click a button and maybe just have it like, I don't think it should automatically be sent via Discord or web link. Fuck no. Too much integration. Click a button and download a CVS file. Wow. That. Yeah, it seems okay, but it seems like someone was like, who's in chat? Who's the guild officer in chat who's been whispering to the developers that this is needed? Oh, I not call my phone. Do you guys not have phones? I mean, I don't understand why we don't have like what is it? Having another second authentication system, right? Dual authentication. When I log into my Outlands account, I want to know that I am protected from the hackcore community, and I would like a little ping to go to my phone for me to agree to set login session. I would like to know the IP of that session. And then I would like a 5-digit hash code that I need to enter back into my client in order to log in. Thank you, Owen. No, I like, let's be real. Jokes aside, I think there's probably some positivity that can come to this. I also think you're way overestimating how hard the in, like how big the in-game PvP scene is from a loot perspective. I'm like, what? Who's getting the MCDs tonight, guys? Like, holy shit, guys! It's just a redistribution of gold at the end of the day. That's all it is. Throw it out there. Let it be random. Like, the roster thing I get. I think going to Discord as a web link is you've scope creeped this, guys. Get it to a CSV file. Let them download it. They can import it to Excel, Sheets, or whatever the fuck kind of program they want to use. And do what they want with it from there. Done. As far as, like, who's been attending the events, I mean, let's be real. Keep up with it yourself. Like, I do not need this for fucking Outlands. Oh, what is Echo up to? You know, what's their world first fucking progression look like? I don't need this. Like, ooh, who's on the charts today? Where's my data at? This you do not need for Ultima Online. And when I read this, a comprehensive guild roster showing dates of all recruitment promotion. No. What was it? Add progression tracking for guildmaster for dungeon bosses and trade caravans to see which guilds, and then also looking at like who's there and all that. I'm like, do we need data coming out of the game in order for us to keep up with a 27-year-old wizard game that we used to play on AOL? Nah. All right. I'm not saying don't do it. I'm just saying priorities. Guild prestige unlocks. Add a number of new prestige unlocks, including a large number of high-end ones requiring large amounts of prestige. Fuck off. No. How about we add guild prestige unlocks to promote the creation of more new guilds and smaller things that will incentivize good communities, not the nut-hucking, sweaty motherfuckers on the server? I agree for the high-end ones, but when I see shit like that, I clearly can tell who is talking to Owen and the dev team getting this entire fucking section. It's probably two of the sweatiest guilds talking about the big shit. Like, guys, I want to hear about how you're going to make it good for everyone, not the probably three guilds on the server. That you got to watch out your wording, because this right here, this section, and then reading a one-liner that says high-end rewards for guilds that have large amounts of prestige means fuck off everyone that hasn't been here for 3 years. I don't care if you're a new guild. We're not focusing on you. You know what I mean? Am I out of line by saying that? I mean, I know I'm slamming it pretty hard, but am I out of line by saying it could have been worded a little bit better? So, that's all I'm saying. The nut-hugging, sweaty motherfuckers are the ones that drop $5,000 on donos a month. True. Guild lore, 0% completion. Guilds will have the ability to write books and submit them for staff approval. I think we've reached the bottom of the list, guys, because I don't know how we can get any dumber than this. I have lore right now. Exclamation donate. To be able to find out where my donation vendor is in the game today, just north of Andoria, you can buy customized books written by me, Laginus, that cost anywhere ranging between $25,000 and $100,000 with thank you notes. It says thank you notes by Laginus, how much you've donated, and a little bit of a thank you for supporting the stream comment. You can put it in your house today and support me now. Also, for you sweaty, nasty motherfuckers out there that want the real lore, there's a pair of my pants sitting there on the vendor right now from a day's worth of farming in Aegis Keep for 1 million gold. You can buy my sweaty drawers. Also, for you real nasty, kinky motherfuckers that I know have way too much fucking money on your hands, there is one item. And only one item will ever be sold on this server. It is a locked chest containing my bath water in it for 5 million gold. You want lore? You create it yourself, guys. You do not develop it in your game. The players will create their own lore. That's all I'm saying. Exclamation donate right now. All right. Monster Arena, 5% completed. This already sounds fun. We'll see where we go. Approved by the fucking staff. What is this, fucking Russia? Introduce a PVM-focused monster arena where players tackle waves of different monsters and compete against other players to try to reach the highest wave count in the fastest time frame. This sounds amazing. Take out the time frame. I'm just offering my tidbit advice from the experience where we've seen a lot of these features, these kind of roguelike features, get added into other MMO games like Final Fantasy and World of Warcraft. Adding a time-based element usually ends up kind of killing it a lot of the time. And it makes it to where it feels like the player has to rush. And the name of the game is running and not like doing tactical things, skill-based things, or giving them a capability to actually go and take a shit in the middle of a run. So depending on how long these things are going to last. I absolutely love this idea. I'd look forward to seeing more content or more discussion and more topics around this in future posts. Yeah. I have nothing but positive vibes to say about that. I think tracking it in the fastest time, sorry, I might have read this differently or interpreted the meaning but differently. Fastest times sound fucking amazing. Just please don't put timers on them, is what I'm trying to say. I like speedrunning. Yeah, that'd be cool to know, oh my god, he got to fit like level 15 in 5.5 minutes, fucking breaking the record by fucking 3 minutes. And this was his build. You know, and adding it to where you can say, like, you know, it says what their build was. Like, this was their chain, this was the aspect they were in, and this was their loadout. Because you can anchor that into the loadout systems that you're developing and your other things. You see where we're going? We're making modularization in your systems to where the thing you developed over here is cascading into the thing and complementing the thing over here. This is a good fucking idea, and I absolutely love it. The lore book system, which probably could have, is also talking about the guild lore, but we'll see. We will be finally updating the lore book system to have new content for missing dungeons / towns, as well as more general lore in the Outlands world. We will be working on addressing the differences between pages 10 to 15, page 15 and 10 page collections. I guess if, I don't know what the lore book system is, but I guess that makes sense if you do. Additionally, we're adding some new lore books that will be overhauling the difficulty on existing ones. I don't know what this is, but the fact that they had to put the word finally with an exclamation mark and a bracket sounds like it's wanted. So, yeah. I mean, if it's a wanted system, anything that's going to add a little bit more story and understanding to a game, that's a really fucking cool thing, right? New customizations. Sorry. They need to make it to where you have pre-made build characters or customizations you pick you want. On the runs? That would be badass. Like, literally kind of create, like they already have the concept on was it Strangelands? Where you kind of pick and go. It's literally taking Strangelands and turning it into a soloable event. That you could unlock through various things and, like, you weave different systems. Like, oh, man, am I going to get this or that? Stuff like that. Or, like, this ability or unlock that. Oh, shit, I just unlocked a barding ability. Dude, you could take that and do a whole entire fucking thing with it. That could be a really fun thing. Like, really think of a roguelike encounter. Also, just being able to take a pre-made build that you have and it just kind of snapshots what it was and then trying to clear a shitload of waves would equally be cool. And I think that would probably be a little bit easier to develop than a roguelike game. But both of those systems, I could get behind 110%. Equally, I think those systems, if they weren't just, like, generally always available, if those were systems for, like, super treasures, they kind of like the Winterlands card, but, like, more of a permanent-based system. I think those are, I like that, those kind of chases where, like, there's things that you can get and they're rare in there, but they have to have the loot turned up a little bit higher. So, like, listing, like, a permanent Winterlands card without the paragraph of text or in a torch event, but let's just say the concept of the card drop, or the ticket drop, and then you can take the ticket, and then you go to the castle, and you do the thing. But the thing has, like, a really high loot chance, because it needs to reward the fact that you got the ticket, not that you got a ticket, and then you got a dud, and you only got 900 gold. You know what I mean? I mean, why make a character... I mean, when you make a character, have it... So you have a UO Outlands working template, and even puts the skills in the same tab. Yeah, that'd be pretty cool, dude. Yeah. So I'm just saying, like, these systems, these, like, repeating systems, there's a lot of good discussion around that, right? So, all right, so new customizations. 20% developed. Any large array of new player... add a new large array of player customizations for gold sinks. Oh, shit. Possibly including... Llama Vortex? Energy Vortex? I saw the llama thing, so I guess that's technically there. I guess these are all new customizations going down, so let's roll through that. I'm all about the gold sink, baby. Llama Vortex is in-game. Okay, so that was saying that. So these are going to be new customizations. I'm already kind of eyeballing the picture in front of me, and I can't wait to get into it, so let's fucking get into it. Golems. Alright, so... 10% status, create a new system for players to craft summable golems that can be highly customized based off the player's skill and slotting in certain items into golems such as aspect cores. I'm not liking this as much as I thought. Golems will be 5 control slots and will be the opportunity for players with crafting skill to access a summon type creature that will be extremely customizable based on their skills. What this is going to end up being is essentially all those little things that they've turned on for crafters, right? To make them more viable in PvE or PvM, is then they're going to get their golem, and then the new meta is going to be like, fuck tamers, fuck bards, fuck necros, fuck summoners, fuck poisoners, fuck stealthers. It's all about the crafting game, baby. Get your blacksmith, get your tinker, get your tailor up to 120, get your fucking golem made, and smash tier 4 dungeons. I'm iffy on this, guys. I am. What I was thinking when I saw this and my brain was processing the image without the text was, here's a new customization for gold sinks, and I saw that, and I thought those would be tiers to upgrade the earth elemental summon, and I could pay, like, look at Path of Exile and its monetary means, and I'm not saying you have to monetize it, guy, for the dev team, guys. I'm not saying you have to necessarily monetize it, but it's not a stupid idea. But being able to get spell hue deeds specifically through a cash system and not an RNG system, they could do something like that right there and overhaul the graphic of what your elemental looked like, or overhaul, like, the intensity of your lightning. Like, maybe when I cast lightning, it fucking hits like 4 fucking times graphically, or it has like high definition lightning that happens. Like, that is a... I swear, this is like my wife signaling me to, like, say, hey, thanks for Sigma. The red bar actually, adding me actually helped catch my eye. I plugged it in. Let's do this. All right, hold on. All right. Get something for my headphones to register so they don't auto turn off. They hated this idea the UO server nuked his headphones. So I don't know where I cut off, but I'm going to circle back just a little bit, all right? Play League of Legends. Are you talking about Lux skins? Oh, my God. Haha. In-game, but have tier 13 at the crafters. Yeah, dude. Yeah. All right, so where I was going with this is have an in-game system to on gold to essentially start murdering the high-end. Like, what was it? One dude saying he had 40 million gold? And he was crying because he already gave 200 million away. That's fucking a stupid problem to have. And an amazing problem that one day I hope I have. Alright. And by buying my bathwater, we can hurry up and get there. So, what I'm thinking is have it to where... I don't like the golem idea. I think that's trash. For crafters... If you're a fucking crafter, stay the fuck in your house. That's it all. That's all. I there seems to be this niche need to turn crafters into player like PVMers. I got an idea. How about you turn tamers into PVMers? There's a hot fucking take right there, guys. But I'm going to digress on that hill and say what I saw here with that picture was a 10 million gold upgrade to the Earth Golem per color or spell hues. Or like hues that you can unlock as a secondary stat to the primary stat being I want this Earth Golem 10 million gold. Now I want to have these colors for that unlock 5 million gold per color. You just eliminated for the guy who wanted all the fucking hues, probably like 50 million gold off of one account just for the Earth Elementals. You could circle back and have it to where lightning literally strikes like 4 or 5 times, and it's like this like lightning effect, and it's high resolution lightning just for your lightning spell, and it doesn't apply to chain lightning. That's another like 20 million gold, and you could like literally overhaul the spells and other things in the game from a graphics perspective. That you're right, really adds to it. I think you could make it to where like the bards have musical notes that play. I don't know what you can do for dexers. Maybe make it to where they have an ability instead of just hitting tab and raping everything. Aha. I don't know. Maybe make it to where they actually have animations. Although that would be a bit of a cock move to add animations to the dexers world to where it doesn't look like they're auto attacking everything, but secretly all they do is auto attack everything. The zero skill game, right? Right, right. Fuck dexers. But, But I think that, like, really looking at that, I think that's a good chase. I don't think golems are that great of an idea. Not for the crafter idea. I think you're onto something when you look at making a monetization of gold to be able to sink things into the game. And I think having it to where, show me on the doll where the dexter touched you, it's in all the holes. It's in all the holes. But, But I think seriously though, the customization around spell graphic increases, it could be looked at as distasteful, but let's be real, from a dev perspective, you're gonna do one of two things with that idea. Or one of three. You're gonna give it to everybody for free, which you know you're not gonna do. You're gonna monetize it for prev coins, which I don't think you should do. Or you use it as a gold sink to get rid to help aid players who have way too much fucking gold, and to give chase for people who are looking to, you know they've got a lot of the in-game systems done, and they're looking for a chase in the game. They want something to say, go back to the dungeon and grind. Plus, you're gonna need a monetization chase anyways when you introduce tier 15, because all the sweaty motherfuckers who never play in their tier 14 gear, right, and they start grinding a stupid amount of time for experience in those, is going to bring in a vast hundreds of millions of gold, hundreds upon hundreds upon hundreds of million of gold into the economy, and you're going to look at an economical boon. You need to have something to kill that gold. This could be one of those solutions. Server rank, The last one, guys, developed at 75%. I believe this is already in the game, and I like it. I was looking at it earlier. Really, really cool shit. Wiki and guides. Development status, 0%. That is so fucking accurate. Speaking, they already have a wiki they have. And who needs your guides? I'm going to go and check on the fucking YouTube and on the internet for player ran guides, because they're the ones playing the fucking game and giving me guides on how to be overpowered in the fucking game. Developers should not be writing guides for how to shit on the game. And players don't normally read developer guides, because they're going to look at someone who's shitting on it and not someone who's following the rules of doing this to, I don't know, go hunt bears because bears are fun. Fuck that. I'm going to show you how to get your experience system. Skip half the shit that you built for us for developing. Go macro in a fucking corner and fap to some shit on another monitor and be done with the goddamn thing. That's why player man guides are made. So I don't know if I agree to that. General things would probably be okay, though. Pwn Star guides! Abso-fucking-lutely. Abso-fucking-lutely. Like, there is not going to be a leveling guide that says, go get in a guild that gives you free regs and stand here and run a JSON script off this site and work up magery, come back, go to sleep, come back, and you're a GM mage. No guide from any type of self-respecting developer in their own product would ever mention to go do that. Every fucking player will, though. Why? Because fuck leveling magery in the open world. Am I fucking right, Fizzle Boys? Am I fucking right, Fizzle Boys? That ain't gonna fucking happen. Alright, guys. This took a little bit longer than I thought. Because the Sealers game started 35 minutes ago, and I was just looking to try to kill some time before the game. What we now know is there is a lot that the developer said they had planned on tackling, or wanted to try to tackle, for 2022. Especially since this was posted originally in April of 2022. I am hopeful that this meant to say 2023, because there's a lot of shit here. There's a lot of shit here. So my big takeaways, and there's some stuff beneath this, and I'll look at this here in a minute. Here's my general stuff. Luthius, dude, you're the man. Mad fucking reps. I could only imagine the hours you spent writing this. Like, a shitload of time. Everything I say is from a criticism perspective. In your entire dev team, guys. The entire dev team. Much fucking love. Guys, if you're a sub, I want to get some fucking Laginus UO love in fucking chat for the devs. For this fucking server. And if you're not a sub, sub. But if you don't want to, that's fine. Get some mad hearts. I want to see some hearts in fucking chat for this fucking server right now, guys. Let's fucking get it going. It's not happening, and I want to see it. This server is fucking fantastic, guys. And everything I say from criticism comes from a place of love and compassion. And fuck Dexers. But. I'd like to see a humbling, like, again, I would love to see for 2023... your pipeline, I would like to know, what are you trying to target from a quarter perspective? The generalized things, it doesn't have to be everything aligns to a timeline. That's stupid. That's stupid, and it's going to open you up to way too much criticism. But what are the big ticket items you're trying to do for the year? Whether it's quarter, or we're saying this is what we're trying to do, and these are the things we'd like to chase. Probably structuring the next post around like how things are going to could interlink and lean on each other. So you understand a little bit more from a dependency perspective. That's for me, from a developer, that could be a little bit too much. I would like to see more generalizations of, again, you've got a vendor system for looking at transmogs or looking at outfit sets, outfit customizations. I'll stop using the WoW term. So outfit customizations on an NPC, so you can see it. Then you got a way to save those customizations for your own character and different loadouts to be able to pull them up and recall them. I don't know where that armor goes for those different loadouts, so I'm sure you're working through that. Then you've got another system for making it to where that customization is visible in the game and not just Paper Doll Fan Club, right? And then you've got where you can apply these customizations or new customizations onto armor, further increasing based off the other things. Like, that entire thing could have told a story that you didn't need someone like me to kind of come in and explain, this arc on top of that. I'm sure most people saw it, but still, Like, not everybody's going to catch that. So explaining a lot of, like, what are y'all thinking besides necessarily the individual development features, right? And I think that's going to help bring it into good 2023. Guys, I would love y'all's feedback on all of this. Come on, guys. I want to see more hearts in chat. Y'all love this game. Persigma, where are you at? I see you talking. I don't see your hearts. I'm calling everybody out. I got 38 people. I got some lurkers in this chat, and that's perfectly fine. I want to see some hearts for these developers. They spent a lot of fucking sweat and tears going into this, and it's fucking grade A shit. Like, 2022 was a banger of a fucking year for Outlands, and I'm excited for 2023, guys. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, dude. There you go. There you go. I'd like to see them work on housing and vendor system. It sucks running around looking through all the empty vendors. It's not necessarily hard. It's a little weird having to kind of set up your script, so I understand that. It's a bit of a learning curve, though. If you didn't know, to go to that website, find out where that vendor is, click on the link to download the script, paste the script, run it above your head, and then run around in circles in that area, and then the vendor bag will pop. Then you click the button again after you stopped running, so the vendor bag pops. Then you go invisible, then you run away after you bike. I get it. Once you yeah, exactly, exactly. Like, once you figure it out, Jason's my man. Once you figure it out, you kind of get it, but it's a little wonky at times. But look, guys. This has been an amazing deep dive into looking at their dev path. Some good criticism and I think some helpful criticism. I plan on trying to circle back and try to make a YouTube video out of this. 20K to for Sigma, LOL. Dude, Jace, I've been using that fucking spin to win with my torches all fucking day. I love it. I love it. But anyways, back to the point. Like, it's... I'm looking forward to seeing their post. Hopefully it doesn't happen in April of 2023. I'm hoping for it in maybe January or February. February would be optimistic. I think January is a bit aggressive. But I'm looking forward to this. And I'm looking forward to this being a little bit cleaned up. I would like to set expectations on what the dev team can actually deliver from a year's perspective versus just puking out their idea backlog. I'd like to see their feature backlog. Like, I think it was a bit aggressive. I think this post was a bit aggressive. So with that, I'm going to call it. I know my Steeler game is starting right now, and I want to go sit down. I've been talking for a bit, and I think I've about lost my voice three times over. So my stream is going to sound very interesting tomorrow. Thank you all for coming out and supporting the stream. Thank you all for chilling with me while I'm sitting here macroing two characters right now. I am ecstatic. For those who have joined in and are going Aegis down onto the six, I got the Aegis torch today after a week and a half of farming. I got the Aegis torch today. I got it about an hour and a half into my stream. 10-hour streams. Buddy, I did a 22.5-hour stream just for having fun earlier this week. I have been grinding Twitch, but I'm on vacation. This shit's about to stop. I'm not some rich guy hanging out and all this shit. Like, nah, fam. Come Tuesday, you'll be seeing me for like an hour or two, a few days a week, and then probably a little bit heavier on the weekends. Sweet baby Jesus, I got to work tomorrow. Sad. I fortunately have tomorrow off as a holiday, but Tuesday, I'm back into it. From tomorrow, I'll be busy. Yeah. Guys, don't we all miss the holidays? We all love our little winter breaks. This is a good song as an outro. I like this. Alright, everybody. Rip our free time. Dude, you're about to see the server gold per hour the payouts just go like... Phew! And think about those sweaty people that can fucking farm the servers now. During their days, they're like, yeah, finally get my torch game on. All those fuckers going back to work. I'm actually looking forward to tomorrow because I'm hoping to get some Oswery done before everybody comes home. But, alright, guys. I've been talking, and I can continue to talk because I'm having a lot of fun just shooting the shit. I'm glad to have a very active chat tonight. It has been phenomenal shooting the shit with everybody. We've seen people come and go, but man, it has been a lot of fucking fun. It has been a lot of fun. Jace, I'm glad I can say this on my end. Thank you so much for everything you do for the server. It's amazing. It's fucking Giga Chad amazing. It's so good. It's so good. I forget. There's somewhere. I don't know if you've been here the whole time. There's somewhere in here where I was actually cracking. That was like, this is at 0%. I feel like Jace Owens could knock this out in a week. I forget where it was. Oh, whatever. That's going to open up a 30-minute door windows if I start scrolling down this thing again. All right, guys. Have a good evening, morning, afternoon, or night, wherever you are in the world. Thank you so much for the support again, and have yourself a good one. I will see y'all tomorrow.